Well, welcome back, guys, to the grid track. Right now, speaking for you is the Java champion, Mohamed Taman. The stage is yours, dude. Thank
you. Hvala puno.
Zdravo svima. Yes, I know a little bit Serbian, but not a little bit. Somehow it's quite good because I live here. I'm Egyptian. I moved here since 2017 because of this conference, actually. And I didn't hear about Serbia before, just in the news. But when I came just to visit one country in the Balkan, I loved you so much as a people. It's pretty close to Egyptian culture. And they asked me, would you like to work for us? Like, why not? Let's see. Then since I moved, I couldn't get out. You know, I'm here stuck for 5 years. But I loved it. So I'm originally from Cairo. I lived in Egypt all my life, traveling worldwide speaking. I'm participating in Java and community since 2008. So I acquired a little bit like humbled knowledge about Java and Jakarta E and Java E and the community and all of this kind of stuff. My main focus now, recent years, about GDK, because we have a lot of improvement about GDK and things going on and misunderstanding. And also when you go to universities to teach, people say like, I would like to learn Scala, Python, TypeScript, things like why Java, it's very hard, it's very old, it's very like, but people doesn't know. This is why the question is Java still relevant and worth learning in 2023? This is, I wrote an article about this in my old company and it's published. So yeah, let's start because we have a lot to say and I hope that time could make it. So as my brati just pronounced my name, Mohamed Taman, and Taman ka serbiskan, just Taman. I'm working as a as a solution architect. This is my main job. My vertical experience is Java and Java ecosystems, but horizontally I'm solution architect, even whatever the front-end engineering, data, cloud, all of this kind of stuff. So I have some publication, but I usually write my articles in Java magazine. Now there I have for Oracle and IBM Developer and MVQ, so you'll find my stuff out there. I will share the presentation. It has all the links. Those are links. So this is the latest about Java 21. I go deeper, not just the features, because the language is not the features, as we will see. And you can catch me at any time in these links. And I will just, you know, Google my name in Google, and you'll find all of this very easy, so you don't have to bother. One just note, my GitHub contains all my application and blueprints, and it's always updated. So latest spring, Jakarta EE examples, and Java latest. So you will find migration. You will find even in the comments how things moved from stuff to stuff. When I speak about spring migration and Java, also I have relevant articles and as well as a project. So you can see and you know what is the difference, is what I change it from time to time. You are welcome to change anything, fork it, do whatever you want. Our agenda today, we are going to speak like history, not too much. You know, you are expert more than me in this. What is LTS? Because this is a very confusion, introduce a confusion for some people. So I was going always asked, does this version LTS 3 years, 4 years, 2 years, why it's this schema, how it works? And then we will check out some opinionated features from 11 to 17 to see even the Java evolution. Why we need to learn this language and how it's make it easy for us and more performant and professional way to do, as my colleague here in the previous presentation mentioned about data oriented, especially, and this is very important thing because we are around the data. And also we will check out from 18 to 17 because this is another milestone that we have. Finally, we will have some resources. So if I'm speaking about Java history, and they always get this confusion, you can see that all times we have Java every 3 or 4 years, actually. And you can see it here from GDK 8 to 9, we took almost, you know, 3 years. And in current era of like development, to stay this time of amount of time to wait for a language to come for you to solve, I will go to another language to solve my problem quickly now, even if it's robust language. But Java is not something simple. It's not just a language, it's an ecosystem. This is some people doesn't understand. When we release, it's a bunch of companies steering these releases. Either Jakarta EE, it's a specification led by 21 company. I was GCP member. It's called Java Community Process. So you'll find Microsoft, Red Hat, Google, Apple, SAP, Goldman Sachs, even many, many companies, Oracle as a steering committee. So we have decisions we have to decide because all these people are building tools above Java. So we have to agree what is it. Then they have the competition. So this is why then we came like now in the era of cloud, we have data, we have big data, we have data lakes, data warehouse. We need to speed up. We have data around everywhere. So we have to be easily deployable and also reduce the size and taking this advantage of everything, containerization, orchestration, all of this. How can I help? We came to the schema of 6 months release cadence. So Java 10, 9, from 9 to 10 and 10 to 11, there are no big changes. It was, you know, you have a new release schema. So we were testing, does it gonna work or not, literally. And since 11, it works successfully. Then when we cleaned up stuff, we says, okay, this is why you will find a big difference between, see the number of features here, like 90, this is the main features. I didn't speak about the bunch of classes and enhancement in the API, because the language is not just the main feature that you see that which require some amount of time to work on it. But there's a lot of enhancements, security, background compatibility, a lot of additions for classes, for string, but we will not mention it as a GEP. Java Enhancement Proposal, as you're gonna see. Then we have quite smaller number of features, but a lot of enhancements, so it's speed up. So this is very important. So what is LTS? You know what is LTS, right? Long-term support. But why I would like to mention, because we changed this as a Java community for, it's a marketing concept for each company, and also it related to specific vendor. So it doesn't mean that when we announce that the release cadence becomes 2 years, every 2 years we will have LTS. This is recently, last year it has been made at the decision. Instead of 3 years, we will have it 2 years. But it's for Oracle. So you can find vendors, you know, the changes, as I told you, you can find vendors like Azul have medium time support, have support for the feature-based release, which is took only 6 months between, you know, you have 2 or 3 releases between LTSs. Once the 6 months finished, you don't have support, but some people can support it. You know, Azul does that. So for how long the LTS lasts? Usually from 6 to 8 years. Then the 2 other years is overlapping between the next LTS. So you can have time to move to the new version. And what the MBEC does in this kind of things, bug fixes covered for a long time, you have performance improvement, indeed new features, vulnerabilities fixed, and commercial support. So this is the main question. So if anyone asks you LTS, you need support, you have to ask the vendor, how does they support it? Because you don't have to assume it, it's just only 2 years. This is very important. So let's check out some features, not all of them, because I will not have room. I hope to have a room even to cover those. But I want to tell you something. Java, literally, is not about the language. All the Java community and development, we are focusing on the GVM. This is the core. Because GVM is, this is where you can run Kotlin. This is where you can run Scala, Groovy. It's the GVM is the core. The language, you can use whatever language, but can you use it outside of the GVM? No. This is the polyglot, you know, paradigm. So the GVM for us is the core. Java is a synthetic sugar, but we used to just relate both of them. Java is a synthetic sugar as a language. I can learn it, but I can do in Kotlin. I can do whatever you like. You make use of the feature. You can mix both of them. But I'm stuck with Java nowadays because, yes, it provides a lot of enhancement. This is why you will see moving to Java is not language features only. It's GVM, it's performance, memory management, bug fixes, security plan, have a plan aside. You can go to check it. It has a plan for migration and catching with vulnerabilities. It's something different. So as you can see here, Java 11, when we have introduced it, Java 11 was the first LTS release with the new release cadence. This is the people to rely in and to get used to this. So you can find for some, like there is no major changes in the language. We have just local variable syntax for lambda expressions. But see the GVM, we have a lot of enhancement. This is why when you move from 8 to 11, you have 60% performance out of the box without even changing anything. Because we have a lot of enhancement and a lot of garbage collection also has been introduced to support wide variety of cases, like especially for data, for off-heap memory management, like Spark is doing this, you know, because you don't need to consume your application memory and just shut down or in the cloud, you are using resources. No, I need something off the heap, manage it, just come back to my application, which is 2-3 giga, and I can use off the heap of the operating system like 3-4 more giga. Then I finished my job and I constrained to my limit. So this doesn't grow your application. You don't have to create an instance with initially 10 giga. Because of some time, I will use all of them. So this concept is very important. And as well as there is new APIs. Now I can do all the HTTP 1, HTTP and WebSocket calls and asynchronous and synchronous from GDK. I don't need any external libraries to do this anymore. So we have introduced HTTP client. You have Unicode always support because we are using, you know, data and we need to maintain the scripts for the new additional data. And then we have deprecation. This is the first time. Yeah, we have deprecation all the time, but we never remove. Which the reason? Background compatibility. But if you need to move forward, you have to make compromises. So we decided all things that doesn't need support, we will remove it. We will clean. So LTS 11 was the first cleaner for the jungle in Java. So we have deprecation and we have removed firstly everything related to Java EE because this is GDK only and moved outside Corba modules. It's very old system. Why I have to support it and so on. And then we always deprecate. And we have a new feature, deprecation for removal, and we set it to true flag. Usually it takes from announcement of the deprecation to removal, like 2 release cadence. Then you know that we will remove, but we will provide alternative solution for this. So Java 12, something this is was language feature. You know, in Lambda, we can use it, declare data types, right? And also we can remove it. But why I have to support using var? It's useless here, right? Because I can do it this way or this way. In Java 11, this is very important because we need, annotation needs data type. And to make it much easier, you don't have to have a very big data type. You just use var and that's it, and it will work. This is a small enhancement, but it was common use case. In Java 11 also, there is a very nice feature that I loved it myself that, you know, in old days, you have to have simple class like this. I have to compile it to dot class, then I run it. Now we can run it just Java with Java. What does it mean? Compilation memory. We added for learning for the students. So you don't have to have extra step to learn and to compile. Just run, test your code immediately. But there is a new additional feature will bring more power, which is shell scripting with Java, shebang files. If you have a source code, literally in Java, and you just included the first line, this one, and you just, you know, save it the name that you want, it doesn't matter the name, it breaks the rule. No, because this is in-memory compilation, so I don't care about the class name. Just making executable, it will be bash file, and you can run it like this, just ./dir/list, and it will work. What does it mean? For me, I was always trying to do my black box testing using bash script. No, I now, because they are like, I have HTTP client, I write it in Java, I'm expert, I do my stuff, I run it from command line. So I don't need to write in bash anymore. I can test my application and do all my black box testing using my new paradigm. So it's very important. HTTP client, it's very easy. This is how it is. If you want to build client, it's like this. Then you call it async or sync. If I would like to have a WebSocket, I have to implement listeners, you know, for the methods listening, and I can create WebSocket like this. And it has all the features, security, proxies, whatever it is. Okay, Java 12, what does it bring for us? Java 12 was the first release that introduced a preview feature. Do you know what is preview feature? Okay, so I will not speak about it. I'm joking. Preview feature means I am giving you a feature of the language, but it's still under development. It's not stabilized. So in order to have it, you have to, it's called feature behind the flag. You have to provide for your compiler or J shell or anything, dash dash enable preview, because it has different compilation source version. But it's on your risk. Why? Because we might change it. We might remove it. So it worked for both incubators and preview features. So for example, we start to introduce switch expression as a preview feature. And we have done a lot of changes over the time until we stabilize it. And then you can see also that we have a lot of GVM enhancement, bringing a new garbage collection, some porting more to make Java available and for different operating systems, and also enhancement in the default garbage collection G1, GC, because different use cases, and then also new API. This is for micro bench testing. We have open sourced it. We use it internally to test the API benchmarking, not the system. So if you have two algorithms, you would like to see which is performant based on the case, you can use micro benchmarking. So it's quite less, definitely, but you are improving over the time. This is to give you also opportunity to learn. Java 13, you see minimum features, but bunch of enhancement in the background, security-wise and classes-wise. So we have another version of two-net preview for Switch. Why? Because the community, which is you as the developers, give feedback, don't use this keyword because it doesn't make sense, use another one. We listen, we change, and then we give you back. So it gives opportunity that I don't have to design something, give it to you as it is, and you don't share your feedback. It gave us a great feedback to change and give you what you want as a developer. And it works amazingly. GVM definitely has to have enhancement and some re-implementation for legacy sockets to get aligned with Loom project, virtual threading. So it takes very long step, by the way, to introduce virtual thread. You have to work on the GDK first to be aligned with the project, then give it to you as an applicator. So Java 14, for the first time, we have standardized switch expressions. We give a bunch of GVM enhancement. There is a lot of deprecations and the new APIs. And we introduced foreign memory and access API. This is a new enhancement how you can access memory in an efficient way and also access C++ libraries in more efficient way without the old GNI API, Java Native Interface, which was security problems, performance problems, and it wasn't quite easy to use it. What is the main features that we have here? This is the old ugly switch statement, right? And if you forget one break, you're debugging and cutting your hair and waiting, and man, you just forget a break here. Why we have to have this? Okay, this is the old one. Let's make it easy, because it was borrowed. We borrowed it from C++. And this is the new statement. So you don't have, you use arrow token, just it means you don't have break, just return the value. And also, why not to have it as an expression, not just a statement? What does it mean? It's assignable. It can return a value. So I can enhance this to this. So I get rid of the return statement. I get rid of the string removal value. I don't need them. Just when you case it, return the value. So it's assignable. So it's more enhancement. And this is something else. If we need multiple cases, if case 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, do this. And then you break. But this is also lengthy. We can just improve it to be like this, comma separated. And also, we changed the break to be, this was the community. This is break, what does it mean break value? It means yield value, generate value. Why the change? Because I used colon. If you used colon, means there is something has to happen. Return value, do computation or something. But it has to use yield. If you don't use arrow token, then you could just, it means return the value immediately. So this is the difference. We need to use this and this. So let's see, very nice one. I loved it myself. And this is about null pointer exception that we get all the time. This is very simple, easy, you know, example. That if you have it, you know, if you have null pointer exception, indeed, A is null. But what if you have something like this, A.B.C.I? I have to debug to understand either it's A or B or C is null. But when you enable a flag, this flag, you will get this exception. Exception at read main at this point because I cannot read field C because A.B is null. Then you have much more easy information about the null pointer exception than before. And it's enabled by default since Java 16, so you don't need to enable it anymore. So 15 had standardized text block, introduced sealed classes along with pattern matching and record for second preview. And also, you'll see always there is GVM enhancement. We are focusing on the performance. And also APIs has been introduced for security and, you know, mathematical equation and foreign memory API is very important for us for project Valhalla. And then deprecation more. And then removal. When I remove means, yeah, how could I use JavaScript inside? Yeah, you have GraalVM. You can do JavaScript inside. So we don't need to maintain it. And remove a Solaris Spark port because it's deprecated operating system, so there is no more need to maintain it, which is waste of the engineering time and support. And make it more clearer. Then we all times, SQL statement, composition of JSON string, XML string, HTML, we do this bunch like pluses, you have to align and all of this shit. Then now, we can just write it like this. So I use this always in my data repositories in Spring Boot to have my beautifully aligned the SQL statement. And easily also you can substitute values, but I will not go here in deep because you can see dot formatted and just have some variables inside and you can substitute it. But there is a new feature which is much more better than this. We have introduced it for more security also. I will mention it later on. 16 came with like OpenJDK and this time has been moved to be open sourced out of the community. And we moved it to GitHub. So now you can just check the code, you can see you can open PR, you can contribute, you can see everything, what's going on even in the future. You can see the discussion. So we have pattern matching, for instance, of first introduced, record has finalized and introduced here. Warning for value-based, this is for future enhancement, to make the, how to call it, instance variables, which is wrapper classes, act as primitive data types. So you don't need synchronization on them anymore. You don't need to have them as an object. No, they are reference. They are equal to each other. This is why we introduced this feature. Any value-based, like, what does it called? I give up. Optional. Optional is a holder. Why it has to have, like, you know, synchronization? No, it's value-based. It will be a notation. So we are enhancing more and more. Then sealed classes to need preview because it needs more feedback. The work was different. Once we standardized record, we enhanced sealed classes to work with record too. So it was journey. Then we have those, also enhancement. We introduced Windows architecture 64-bit for more availability, more APIs, and we introduced Vector API for complex vector computation. It's not the vector class that we use as a collection because there is a lot of always confusion about this. And then we enhanced the foreign linker API. This is introduced linking to the new classes outside of the GVM. Like I would like to get some features from C++ direct accessing. So this is the API for make it easy. In my articles, you will find a very good examples how we use all of this. And then internal, we upgraded the GVM access to native to use C++ 14 language feature. As I told you, migration from Merkle to Git, and then moving to GitHub. This was the main focus, just to have more collaboration. See some features? Record. Record mainly was data carriers, it meant to be, because we always have VOs and DTOs. VOs and DTOs, and always there is a lot of ceremony that we can have, and repetitive and error-prone things that we have to take care of. Very simple example. This is point class with 2 points. I'm creating constructor. I have X and Y. I have to maintain equal hash code, 2-string. And what if it has 10 variables? Do so. Do we need this just only for data carrier? So why do we have to have all this ceremony? While simply we can introduce it like this. So where is the 2-string? It's implemented by default. Where is the hash code and equal? It's implemented for you by default. Can I access it? Yes, you have no getters anymore, by the way. It's just only .x, .y. Why? Because there is no setters. It's immutable. It's just when you create it. And these are data carriers, algebraic data, actually. So it's more cleaner, and they are final by default. They are final classes. You can implement interfaces, but you cannot extend any classes. And that you can have different constructors, but just for checking or changing them. So you have canonical, which you would like to just assign, check the value and assign. But if you just need to check the values, you have compact format. You don't need just point X and Y if they are equal to certain values, and that's it. It's very important. More importantly, also, we enhanced record to make use it inside the function. Sometimes we do functional programming, and we need intermediate carrier. So something like this. I have a function to do mapping and some stuff, and I need to just declare record in this context. I don't need it outside. You can do this. Or inside the class. So it doesn't have to be separate like before. Pattern matching. This is very important. Why? Because it gives us more control and clearer control over the hierarchy or patterns. So in instance, we used to do it like this. So if we have if statement to return, if all instance of this and case, insensitive o.s.equal.case. So this is like, I have to cast. There is a lot of explicit casting. Why we don't need to need all of this? We just more clearer. We just ask, if o instance of this, assign it the return value to CIS. And you can do checking immediately after that. You don't need to cast anymore. It's more cleaner, and because I'm using pattern. And also, complex cases, I can do something like this. If this object string is instance, it will return true, then it will implicitly assign the value, and then I can to check about the properties of the value in the same time. So it gives you more control even about the pattern. So if you have something like this old way and doing casting, you just have it like this. Was the first long-term support LTS after Java 11, and it was more stable, introducing a lot of stuff. And also it has restored some, this is to make the floating point computation not different. We had 3 ways to compute it. Now it becomes 1 standard way based on the architecture of the hardware. You have the computation, which gives you a lot of like the same computation happen in different architecture. You don't have to switch. You wasn't switching, the GVM was deciding, but it was a lot of work and maintenance, so we decided to have it. Pattern matching for switch has been introduced, CLD classes has been released, so you don't need to have the flag. GVM, macOS has a release, because we're using now silicon-based architecture, so you have to have a port, deprecation and removal as well. And for CLD classes, I will not go deep dive, because my friend here just spoke about it in the term of data oriented in the previous one, but I wanted to say just that if you have sealed classes concept, you know that we have abstract or interface, then you say it like sealed class shape, and then you have permitting some stuff. And to make it like implementation oriented, you can have here public final class. It means it's not extendable anymore to extend, and also you can open for extension, open for modification, closed for extension. This is the concept. Non-sealed class, but only you can have your implementation and then control it based on this. Weird shape, do it your own. But you cannot change any one of those. So we have also, it works, sealed classes work with records, yeah, because final classes, and it also works with record, because do you remember? Records are implicitly final. So you can, it perfectly work with record, and you don't need to specify sealed or not sealed. And this is the combination of sealed classes and record classes is sometimes referred as algebraic data types. Record classes allow to express product types, as sealed classes allow us to express the types itself. We have very nice packaging tool because we removed it, and you can now, you know, package your Java application in many multiple different operating systems easily with just one line like this. So it's much easier, more wider. Let's check about the other ones quickly. A new feature in 18, we don't have a lot, but this is very important. Now you don't have to worry about changing, you know, the or checking about the default character set. Everything now in Java UTF, what you write on Mac, it will be read on Windows. What you write in Windows, it will be read by default on Mac. So you don't have the way that, which operating system do you use, and this kind of hassle. You don't have it anymore. So we have simple web server that you can run it in your static files, and you can test it. Just small one, Java web server, and it will listen to your package, and you can test it simply, and you can override it to have more extensibility. We have code snippet for your documentation. So if you have a code like this in Java doc as implementation, it will appear like this. You can copy it, it will show like this, and it's also aligned with your code. Whenever you change your code, it will be aligned. So you don't miss what you write in the documentation. It will not be outdated. It's always validating, because you can refer to a class and you say, I need just only this. Whenever you change, it will change automatically. You don't have to maintain. And 19, they have record pattern. Sorry, we have, yes, record pattern. We have GVM, definitely we have APIs. And it was the first introduction to virtual thread and concurrency module. In 20, we have record pattern to second net preview, and we have some enhancement, all of them incubator until Java 21 came and introduced all of this for us with new features. And let's jump in the last part of this presentation to see what is this. Sequence collection. We needed a way to have to lead an order approach. You know, you need some orders in your collections. I can access the last, the end, and the reverse. So we have added new collection, new methods like add first, add last, add get first, get last, remove first, remove last. Because we need, I don't have to iterate over. Also, you have sorted set and linked hash set, new methods, reversed. You can reverse automatically. It will give you the view of the data in reverse way. Sorted map and linked hash map. Do you know, later on, can you answer me, like, when, which cases that you can use linked hash map? It's one of the most famous collections that literally you can use it in some sort of way of, like, specific cases. So you have reserved equal on these methods are now available for you for the order of the sequence. And also, for example, before, if you would like to get the first element, you get it like this, iterator, dot next, and then the last one, you get the array size minus one, but now you can just get it like this. You don't need to have more, you know, old style way. We are talking about record pattern. Yes, this is the record. And before Java 1, we have to check this. And the most important part that I use position B to access the properties. And this now you don't need, because you can just define the pattern and you can access X and Y immediately. Before Java 1, for switch, you have to do this way. And after Java, switch also make use of the pattern, so you can access the variables immediately. And record pattern also for this, this is a composition of two records. And in order to match this, you have p.form.x, b from y, and this is too long. Now we can just, using pattern, we have access immediately. Record pattern with the switch is the same. So you can also have it to switch an instance of with f statement. And also this is work with many, many nested record pattern. So this is how you do it in the previous way before Java 21. This is how you do it. Even before, if you'd like to have win and to have to, to check about which pattern it is in order to cast it and to have that form. But now with Java 21, just you could have it like this. And also you can do checking for the properties. So it's much and more controlling than before. Last thing that I told you, we have text block, but we have now templates. So before we do concatenation and include variables, we do plussing, we do formatting, we do dot format, whatever it is, text block or text. But now we have template processors. You can write it like this and substitute. This is understand, this is A, and this is B, and that's it. So you don't have, there is a security behind. We have many templates, but this is the default one. You don't have to import it. And also you can do calculations. And you can do string like JSON concatenation like this. So no need for more, you know, old ways like this. Last thing, because this are preview feature, but we introduce it for students and people learn more. So unnamed pattern and matching. So and previously, sometimes if you have this, you don't need, do you need E? Do we use E here as a variable, as exception? We don't use it. And also here, I don't use K, right? So I can write it like this, just substitute with underscore. This is why we deprecated in Java 9 to make use it in such cases. So you can use here because I don't use it. You don't need to write the whole pattern and similar to here. And also in this printf, if you don't use, you can just use underscore. This is unnamed variable and this is unnamed pattern, the whole. I don't need it. So I just substitute with underscore. Finally, if you have something like this in switch and they are repetitive, I can just being like this, but I can enhance it like this. I just need string. Last one, this is what the way that we write Hello World. Now, we can write it without any class, just, and this is a valid source file. You can compile it like this, run your code, and where is the public static? You don't need this ceremony. And unnamed classes means I don't have a class, I can declare variables, here is my main, here's a method, and that's it. So, by reaching here, sorry for taking time, and this is the resources that you can check. I will share the presentation. Thank you very much for your time, for your attention. I know it was intensive, but ask me at anywhere. Thank you very much. Thank you for the guys. So see you outside if you have any questions and anything.